clutch there with 10001110101. And before that, you heard Faith No More with Epic from their album The Real Thing, which came out all the way back in 1989, but still sounds so fresh today. I love Faith No More. I love Mike Patton from Faith No More. Little known fact about Mike Patton from Faith No More. He did the voices for the zombies in the Left 4 Dead games. Did you guys know that? That's kind of cool, isn't it? Like, he's a voice actor as well as being an incredible vocalist. But yeah, isn't that a really random little fact? There are some other bits and pieces that he's done as well. Like, check him out on IMDb. You'll be surprised at the amount of stuff he's been involved with. But yeah. And then obviously, as I said, after that, you heard Clutch with 10001110101. Big fan of Clutch. It's just cool music, isn't it? Like, you can't not get down to Clutch. It's just, I love a bit of stoner rock. So I'm going to play you some Nirvana now. I'm going to play you Heart-Shaped Box from In Utero.
I'm
So that was Nirvana with Heart-Shaped Box. I'm sure I didn't need to tell any of you that. I'm sure most of you know who Nirvana are and are familiar with that song. I mean, I grew up with Nirvana and was a big fan of theirs. I mean, they were kind of still before my time, but I got into them kind of, well, as I was growing up, if that makes any sense. Because I was only born in 88, so only 25. But still, yeah, I really liked Nirvana a lot when I was younger. I actually rewatched the video for Heart-Shaped Box again recently, and I forgot how awesome that video is. Go and do yourself a favor and remind yourself of that video, because it's just so psychedelic and crazy. I can definitely appreciate it more now I'm older as well, if you know what I mean. I'm going to play you some Smashing Pumpkins now, sticking with grunge. This is The Bullet with Butterfly Wings.
The world is a vampire. Sent to Jane. Secret destroyers. Hold you up to the flames. And what do I get for my pain? Betrayed desire.
Tell me I'm the only one. Tell
Smashing Pumpkins there with The Bullet with Butterfly Wings. I don't know if it's just me, but I keep seeing famous people who look like famous bald people. Like, I keep seeing people that look like Billy Corgan. I keep seeing people that look like Michael Stipe. Like, it generally seems to be bald musicians, but I don't know what it is. Maybe it's just in Bath, which is where I live, for those of you that don't know. There's just a bunch of bald people who, because they're bald, have decided to dress like they're famous. I don't know. Or perhaps it really is those people, and I just keep seeing them. Although I can't see why either Billy Corgan or Michael Stipe would be in Bath. But yeah, I'm going to share with you guys a little story that happened to me. It was just kind of funny. A couple of days ago, I went to go see my friend, and it was like, I don't know, 2 in the morning, I guess. But I wanted to go hang out with my mate, because he works in bars, so I figured it. Gavin Charlton, I've mentioned him before on the show. But yeah, because he works in bars, he was up late at night, and I was up because of DJing and stuff. So I went to go and see him. And on my walk there, I walked past a bunch of fairly generic, like not to be disparaging, but fairly generic looking guys. Like, didn't look particularly like they were into any specific genre of music or whatever, you know. And when I walked past them, one of them started headbanging and threw the horns at me and was like, "Yeah, Led Zeppelin." And I thought he was taking the piss. So I turned around and was like, "Really?" And they were like, "What?" I was like, are we really going to be this childish? Like, are we?" I kind of thought we got over this kind of thing. Yes, I've got long hair, etc. And they were like, "Oh, no, mate, we're big fans of rock music. Like, we were just at Moles and they were playing loads of great music there." And it was just a really funny, like, misunderstanding thing. And they were just really apologetic. And I was like, "Oh, you guys should come to Discord. Like, you'll really love it." And they were like, "Oh, yeah, no, we definitely will." And yeah, just a really random little occurrence. Like, I was honestly quite in the mood for a fight. To be honest, like, I'm not a particularly violent person, but I was just like, I don't know, I was in that kind of mood where I was like, yeah, and then, yeah, I completely misread the situation, apparently. But there you go. Just shows that sometimes you got another thing coming. Segue, here's some Judas Priest.